So first I'm just starting with Java, core Java again. Okay. Yeah. So I just wanted to show you what is Java, and then we'll continue how the Java will work, how Java is helpful for the development. Okay. And then we'll go with the development, like exactly what kind of applications are there, how to develop all these things. Okay. Fine. So first of all, what we need to understand is in the computer how the Java is installed, like how I should know like Java is available or not. Okay, so for that, what I wanted to do, so first I wanted to understand in my computer Java is installed or not. Okay, for that I wanted to just open command prompt. Okay, I'm type Java here. So if I type Java in the command prompt, it will show you some options. So if it is showing some options here, then my computer is having Java installed already. So na computer lo Java anedi already install ayyindi. So you are able to see the screen and voice, yeah, is yeah. Clear, right?
Everything is clear.
Yeah, fine. So yeah, this is what it is. So if I wanted to know my computer is having Java or not, what I wanted to do, just open the command prompt. I'm typing Java and enter. So if I type Java and enter, it is showing all the options related to Java. So Java command usage, what and all the other options are available. All these things, if it is showing here, then my computer is already installed with Java. Okay. So na computer lo Java unda ledha kanukovalante first em cheyala, నా కంప్యూటర్ లో నేను కమాండ్ ప్రాంప్ట్ ఓపెన్ చేయాలి, జావా అని ఎంటర్ చేయాలి. సో ఇఫ్ ఐ అలా చేసినప్పుడు నాకు ఆప్షన్స్ కనిపించినాయంటే నా కంప్యూటర్ లో జావా ఉంది అని, లేదంటే ఇట్ విల్ షో యూ లైక్ దిస్, జావా ఇస్ నాట్ రికగ్నైజ్డ్ యాజ్ అన్ ఇంటర్నల్ ఆర్ ఎక్స్టర్నల్ కమాండ్. ఇలా ఇలా ఎర్రర్ వచ్చిందంటే నా కంప్యూటర్ లో జావా లేదు అని. ఓకే, so what is this actually meaning? Now this command, whatever I typed, which is not available in computer, that's what it is. So for that, what I have to do, I have to install Java. So for installing Java, all I need to do is I have to download the JDK folder from the official website. I'm going to show you that here. Okay, so you are able to see the screen, right? Okay, you are able to see the screen, right?
Yes, sir.
So this is the official website for the Java. Okay, you just download the JDK. So once you download the JDK, you will get the folder, which is in the zip folder. You extract it. Okay. So that will be the Java for you. So I'm just show you the extracted folder. So this is the folder. So once you downloaded this folder, you will get in this folder all you see this bin, JRE, library, all these things you will see, right? So this is the official JDK. JDK means Java Development Kit. So we'll talk about it later. So in that very important folder is bin. In this bin folder, you see all the commands what we issue in terms of Java development. For example, you just see Java, I just typed right in the command prompt, which is available here. See that. Did you see that Java C? And java.exe, you are able to see this, right? So all these commands, these are the commands which we issue in terms of development or whatever you do in Java. Those exe files or whatever the files which is available inside the bin folder is very important. Okay, so that is what you download officially. So if you wanted to install Java, all you are doing is you are downloading this JDK and setting the path for this bin folder. Why you are setting the bin folder path? Because you are actually using these exe files or the jar files, whatever the sh files, it's related to the again operating system. So since it is Windows, we are actually seeing exe files here. If you download like Linux based JDK, then you see sh files. If you download the related to Mac OS, then you see different files. But bin folder is very important. Inside the bin only, you are seeing all the executable files. In terms of Windows operating system, always you see exe file, executable files. Okay. So if you see Java here, that means what? I just typed here Java means it will actually, whatever it is running here, it is Java, which is java.exe. Okay. So java.exe. If I type java.exe also, the same thing you will see. So generally, if you wanted to run exe file, you don't have to specify extension of that file. That is the actual general scenario. That's what I just typed Java, which is actually running. You are getting it or not?
Yeah.
So this is the bin folder, and this bin folder, once you downloaded, what you need to do? Once you downloaded, you have to set the path for it. Okay. So you go to properties file and advanced settings, environment variable. You will see path variable here, right? So you see the path variable here and here, both the places. This is the user variables and this is the system variables. Okay. Anywhere you can set. What is the difference here? System variables and user variables. Generally, operating system will have users. So for example, if I log in, right, I will have a user over there, right? So it is specific to that particular user. For example, I just logged in as a Sudha user. Now, this path is only for the Sudha. Okay, there will be different users for the operating system. But if you set here in the system variables, it will set for all the users. This is global location. That is the only difference. But apart from that, everything is same. So what you need to do, you go to the path and edit, and you will have so many locations here, and you can put one of the location, this bin folder location. Okay. C program file, Java JDK bin. Okay. So if you put this path here, then what is the meaning? So generally I wanted to use these all the exe files, right? So if I wanted to use all these exe files, what is the common thing is I have to come here. For example, I wanted to come here. I wanted to open the command prompt here in this bin location. Okay. Now I'm in this location and I wanted to issue Java, then it will work. That is the general scenario. So whatever the file I wanted to use, whatever the resource I wanted to use, for example, you have an image in the computer. This image you wanted to open means you have to go to that location to open, right? So I have an audio file in my computer. That file, if I wanted to use, I have to go to that location only, right? So that is the general scenario. Like that, if I wanted to use this exe file, generally I have to go to that location where the exe file is available and I will use it, right? So, but generally this exe file, I wanted to use the entire system. Like I wanted to use in C drive, I wanted to use in D drive, I wanted to use anywhere in my computer. In that case, what I wanted to do, I wanted to set the path to the path variable. If I set the path to the path variable, then automatically it will be available to the entire system. You're getting that? So if I wanted to set this path in the environment variable, then what is the meaning? I can use all these exe files anywhere in my computer. That means, see, I go to, now I'm in a different location. I'm not in bin location, correct? Still I can use Java, enter means it worked. How it is actually happening? If I am just going anywhere, I'm in the C drive now. Still I use java.exe, it worked. How it is happening? Because that location I have kept in the path environment variable. So if I keep this bin location, which is already all the exe files available, if I keep that and configured in the location here in the environment variable, meaning I can use this particular path anywhere in my computer. That's it. Up to this, clear? Any doubts?
No, sir.
Any clarification needed? This is very general scenario. It's an operating system specific. Okay. if you are in Windows, okay, your location of environment variable will be here, like properties file, advanced settings, and environment variables here. But if you are in the Linux, you will have a command to do that, like set path or export path is equal to put the location, that will set the path variable. But end of the day, path is the very important variable for the exe file, executable file. You have to set the path variable. That is the first statement. You can note down if you wanted to note. This is very important because I'm just covering everything from the scratch here. The statement which I kept here is path is the environment variable for all the .exe and .bat files. We have .bat file. I'm going to tell you later that. Okay. So .bat file is something like that is also one of the executable files only. Okay. So these two locations I can keep in path variable because there are so many other variables in the environment. For a different purposes, okay? So if you see here, I can see environment variable. There are so many environment variables here. Android home, right? Java home, JRE home. Right, there are so many environment variables are there. There are different purposes here, and these are the variables. Why it is a variable? Because it's a technical term. Variable means what? Name of the variable will be there, value will be there. So name of the variable and value. So the moment I have a value, that value is read by the any of the other programs in my computer. So my program which I written, that can be read this variable. It's a global location, global variable. This is the location where it's globally available, and any program can be access this variable and read the value. That's it. That is the purpose here. And the JDK is also one of the program which is reading this location. That's it. Okay, like that. And our program also can read. If I wanted to set, for example, my Java code wanted to read one of the environment, it can be. It is possible. So that's all later point that we will see. So any clarification up to here?
No, sir.
Okay. So that is the installation part of Java. Java or any of the exe file, generally any of the, you know, application if you install, that is the only thing we can do. But I just shown you the manual step. The automated wizards will do the same thing, like next finish will do the same thing actually. Okay. So that is the first thing. Second thing what I wanted to tell you here is about JDK. So JDK, what is JDK? JDK means Java Development Kit. So Java Development Kit is a something like a name for the JDK, Java Development Kit. Okay. So in Java Development Kit, there will be two parts. One is again JRE. JRE means what?
Java
environment.
Okay. So and one more part will be JDK only, Java Development Kit only. Okay. So Java Development Kit and Java Runtime Environment. These two parts will be there as part of JDK folder. I'm talking about this JDK folder. Okay. So if I just to show you, again I'll show you that actually. So if you see here, okay, JDK folder is having JRE as well. Did you see that? So JRE means Java Runtime Environment, and which is having again bin folder. And see, there are so many other things are available, and bin is having different things. So what are these difference? If I wanted to think, right? So JRE is a Java Runtime Environment. Java Runtime Environment means this is the engine which can execute the Java applications. Okay, so it is having the capability to execute some of the Java applications. JRE means only it will execute the program. I have a Java program already, I can run if you have JRE. Okay, but if I want to develop anything, you should have JDK. So JDK is a something like capability which is having some developer can use it. Developer will use it and extend some of the features in the Java programs and all. Okay, so that is the difference. Okay, so JDK means it is having development kit. JRE means it is only having the runtime environment. That means only executables. Why it is actually two different programs are available? Why means? Generally, for example, if a end user is there, for example, a user which wanted to just use the application. Okay, so for them, JDK is not available. JDK is a little bit big program, which little bit needed a very big environment and something like hardware is needed, RAM is needed, hard disk is like that. So it's little bit bigger program. So that is not needed for the person who is actually wanted to execute the program. End user don't want. And JRE is a very simple thing. JRE can be installed in a small mobile. JRE can install in a small device like a washing machine. So that your program will execute there. It's a system independent. It can be installed in a small device. If my mobile is having JRE, I can run my Java program in the mobile. But development needed some bigger resources, right? I need IDE, I need a compiler, I wanted to run it, all these things. For that, JDK will be there. That's what. So whenever you have two different things, you wanted to understand. And JRE is different thing. Okay, JRE is a Java runtime environment. If JRE is there, then only your Java program will exist. So you just remember these things. Okay, you will understand at later point. Any doubts up to here? Clear, right?
Yeah, bro.
Fine. So coming to the actual Java part. So what is actually Java? Java is a programming language. Okay. So programming language means what? Programming language means we are actually giving some instruction to the computer, right? Instructions mean what? Instructions means what? Instructions means small tasks. So if I wanted to give it to the computer, I always use some of the programs, some computer programs. Only computer understandable programs, computer understandable languages. I wanted to learn and I wanted to use that programming language only to the computer. Then only computer will understand. So Java is one of the computer language. Okay. So and what kind of language it is? It is actually object oriented language. Right. So that means what? You wanted to understand something here. So what and all types of languages are available in the world actually? We have structure oriented languages. Okay. Second one is object oriented languages. And aspect oriented, right? So what and all types of languages are available in the world, actually in the computer world, means we have three different languages we have, which is structure oriented language, object oriented language, and aspect oriented language. Okay, so these are the different types of languages are available. Okay, one of them, like object oriented languages, if I talk about object oriented languages, one of them is Java. So I'm telling you, these are the three types of languages are there. Okay, in that one of the object oriented languages Java. That means what and all other languages are available? There are so many object oriented languages are available in the world. Okay, it is started with C++. So C language is normal high level structure oriented language. Okay, from C++ we have object oriented languages started, correct? So C is there, then Java, then .NET, there are C#, there are so many JavaScript, all the TypeScript, all the languages are object oriented languages. Okay, so what is object oriented language and all these things later point of time we'll see. Okay, please remember all these things. There are the very, very basic fundamental stuff. In order to learn Java, these are very, very important things. Okay? C, C++, C Sharp, JavaScript, TypeScript, etc. Okay? So there are so many object-oriented languages. Java is one of the object-oriented. Clear, right? So next thing what we need to understand is, what is object-oriented language? So what is object-oriented language? You want to understand very, very basic fundamental stuff here, okay? Everything and anything is object in this language, okay? Everything is object. So in this language, in the computer language, which is object-oriented language in the sense, whatever you do, whatever you write is an object, whatever you develop is an object, whatever you use is an object, okay? Everything is objects, okay? So in the structure-oriented language, generally what you do is a function actually. You write a function and you are using an existing function. You are getting, right? You might be using a library, means in the library you are using functions only. You are developing also functions like that. But in the object-oriented world, everything is object. Okay, and object is very, very important thing in this case, and also very easy thing, very easy to understand. Okay, because the name object itself you'll understand, right? So object is something like real-time world. Whatever we use, right? They're all objects. So everything is objects. So object-oriented language is very, very easy to understand by the human beings. So generally the evolution of language is started with machine language, right? That all we know already. So machine languages are there, and machine language has developed and evaluated as assembly languages, right? And then high level languages. Why all these languages developed? Because machine language is very difficult to understand by the human being, and there are like ones and zeros, like binary language they are using, and it is very difficult to understand by the human being. But it is very understandable, very much understandable by machines actually. Machines means computers, correct? But it has been developed as a assembly language, which is little bit understandable by the human beings, and high level language started. So in this evaluation, high level languages again developed like three types what we discussed already: structure oriented, object oriented, and aspect oriented. In that, object oriented is very much natural, and that is what we are going to learn. So object oriented is very much natural, and that is very understandable by the human beings, right? So in that, everything is object. So what is object, we need to understand, and then object oriented concepts like what is inheritance, polymorphism, okay, abstraction, encapsulation. So all these four very fundamental object-oriented concept we are going to learn. So once you actually learn about inheritance, polymorphism, abstraction, and encapsulation, then almost you cover with object-oriented languages. And I'm not going to cover all these things, because these are already covered topics and very fundamental things. And I'm going to put you some examples, and I'll cover all these things in the later classes, okay?